Show. And now, may I introduce Mr. and Mrs. Will the Thrill.
Everywhere you go, they say that to all the tourists, and they all go, aloha.
Okay, before we continue.
And you did it, so it works.
Let me just correct our announcer. It's Mr. and Mrs. Tiki Goddess. Yay!
Okay, for the next 15 minutes, okay, sure. Yeah. Anyway.
He did legally change his
name. I want to thank the announcer, that's John from Barely Legal, who's handling sound tonight. Rafi and his cohorts handling lights. And you've been watching footage from our honeymoon in Kauai.
Yeah.
And Oahu. I guess you just saw a choice bit. Was that the sex scene? Okay.
Yeah.
I thought I cut that out. Okay, anyway. So yes, we were in Kauai and Oahu over there, and I loved Hawaii. Good thing about Hawaii is that it's still Hawaii.
Unlike Vegas.
Yeah, unlike when you go to Vegas and they pretend they're New York or Paris. You go to Hawaii, you feel like you're in fucking Hawaii. So that's the beauty of it. So, and there's just tikis galore. There's tikis everywhere. You know, here, maybe you don't, but for people who collect tikis, you see a little tiki that big. $50, I'll take it. I'll take it. Look, dude, I scored this tiki, man. Check it out. $50. You only got that for $50? You go to Long's, there's shelves of tikis of all sizes for $5. That's just unbelievable. And you say there, and you try to tell them about the tiki subculture back here. They don't know what the, I'm a babbling mainlander. They're like, why? Why? I don't know what to say. I don't know why.
You're still a babbling mainlander. I feel like an idiot.
Why do I like tiki? No one there has heard of Martin Denny. Has anyone here heard of Martin Denny? Yeah. Which made me even feel, that's like going to Memphis and they're like, Elvis who? No one there heard of Martin Denny.
I would never do that.
But aside from all that, we had a beautiful time, as you can see from the videos, but we're back here in Oaktown and we're here to celebrate in style. And to help us do that, we have all the way from San Francisco, all the way the hell over across San Francisco Bay, we have
Long Bridge.
The legendary, direct from New Orleans, the legendary, because they did a show in New Orleans. That's confusing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. But continue.
Teaser-rama. They did Teaser-rama in New Orleans, and they are the Devil-Ettes are here tonight. Right here on this stage, making a return engagement to the Parkway. They did a big tiki show back in December of 99. And they're here for their encore performance in the East Bay. And also from San Francisco, we have another group I just recently became aware of, the Devil Dolls. The Devil Dolls Motorcycle Club. We're looking at their hogs right here. And tonight, for the first time, the Devil Dolls have met the Devil-Ettes here in Thrillville. That's what Thrillville's all about.
And I think they had some Devil-Ettes.
Bringing people together. Bringing people together. Right. Whatever you say, dear. Okay. Anyway, when I got back, I got pissed off immediately. I had a great time. I opened the newspaper. The AFI,
American Film
Friggin'
Institute.
Idiots, or American Film Institute, their 100 most thrilling films of all time. What I hate about the AFI is that rather than educate the public about films that they should know about that they've never heard of, they just come out, they roll out the same, you know, generic mainstream stuff everyone's already heard of and seen, like, oh, I don't know, Psycho, Jaws, The Exorcist.
Is there Spielberg on there?
There's about 14 Spielbergs. And a Hitchcock, you know, yada, yada, fucking yada, you know, whatever, French Connection. But you know what is not on this list that really pissed me off is tonight's film, She-Devil's on Wheels. Any list, you're gonna name 100 films, thrilling films of all time, you're not gonna mention She-Devil's on Wheels. It's a bogus list. So tonight in Thrillville, I'm going to give you one of the most thrilling films ever made, which is She-Devil's on Wheels. You get that, you get the Devil-Ettes, you get the Devil Dolls. This is a Thrillville honeymoon show. And on top of all that, we're going to give out prizes. So, Well, you're clapping now, but if you don't win anything, let's hear from you later. But is anyone not familiar with Thrillville etiquette? The deal is, Tiki Goddess here, Mrs. Thrill, I mean, Ms. Tiki Goddess, will pick you. I'm going to do trivia. The problem is that when we have spotlights, I can't see a damn thing. So, can you see anything, honey?
A little bit.
So basically, it's going to be like when she spins the wheel. She's going to wing it. So she's going to hit a point in general.
It's an art.
Whatever
it's an
you
art,
say,
not a science.
Whatever you say, dear.
Okay. We got it.
All right. So we got prizes.
So raise your hand. There is no calling out.
So this is the trivia segment. Trivia segment. So I'm going to ask a question. If you think you know the answer, raise your hand. Please don't call out. And I will give you a prize. One thing, we stayed at one of the places we stayed over there was the Hawaiian Hotel, which is recommended to us by our pal Otto von Stroheim, TikiNews.com. And in fact, his wife is Baby Doe of the Devil-Ettes. And so we stayed there, had a great time. Of course, our car was broken into the first night we were there. The problem is that every tourist rents a white Mustang. So there's like this white Mustang convertibles all over the friggin' island. So they know what to hit. You know, chances are you hit a white Mustang, there's a bunch of tourist crap in the back. Fortunately, we'd taken in everything except empty CD cases. I got over there and I forgot my Martin Denny CD and Blue Hawaii soundtrack CD, which are you gotta have when you're driving around the islands, you know? And I figured, I brought a cassette tape because I figured the cars didn't have CD players, but they did, but they didn't have tape players. So I bought the Martin Denny and Blue Hawaii soundtracks over there. It took me a long time to track down Martin Denny, believe me, in Hawaii. It's in the lounge section. What? Never mind, I'll find it myself. I found one Martin Denny CD. So anyway, they took the original cases of Blue Hawaii and Martin Denny. I suppose they were pissed off, you know, about a block away when they opened them up. But anyway,
black criminals.
I've got both of them here. So instead of giving away one, I'm gonna give away both at the same time since they don't have covers, the Blue Hawaii soundtrack and the Martin Denny greatest hits.
These are actual artifacts from our honeymoon.
You do know who Martin Denny is. Please make me feel better. I was going around to bartenders going, you know, Martin Denny, doo-doo, doo-doo, aw, aw, aw. Like, no more for you, buddy, I'm cutting you off.
But whenever he wore his tiki necklace, they said, dude, Craig Brady.
Oh, I had a tiki necklace, a Hawaiian bartender.
He's never
goes,
seen
it. Oh, like Craig Brady, dude. I'm like, anyway.
Moving on.
You want Trivia. Hawaii? You want real Hawaii, you gotta come here at Thrillville.
Okay.
Anyway, I'm gonna give these away to a person who can tell me this. Tonight's film was directed by Herschel Gordon Lewis, one of the great sleaze directors of all time. I mean, there's a little qualification there. But, and he is famous for this film, which I showed recently in Thrillville. His first big hit, this big gore film, was about an Egyptian caterer who's also like a serial killer. Raise your hand and tell me the name of that film.
Leave the Robot!
Leave the Robot, is that the name?
Hey, no, jump on over here!
That was his porno venture.
Yes, sir.
Why was it Teenage Blood Feast? What did he say?
Blood Feast?
Just plain old Blood Feast?
Plain old Blood Feast.
You got it.
Come on down! Wow. Wait a minute, this guy looks familiar.
Now, who is this guy? Hey, wait.
Is he responsible?
Action. This is Strefford Taylor.
You didn't know it was Blood Feast, you idiot!
I can't see shit. I can't even see him with these lights out. On. Out.
And he's hard to miss.
Strefford Taylor. Who wants CDs with no covers? Just take them. Wait. Okay. So yeah, he's a ringer. Strefford Taylor designs my posters. Let's give him a big hand. Speaking of feasts, I have here a gift certificate to the Pacific Coast Brewing Company in downtown Oakland, the second best place in Oakland to get beer and pizza. And of course, you know what the first is, but that's not the trivia question. It comes with a magnetic postcard, Satan Was a Man.
Ain't that the truth?
But we know differently, don't we? Anyway, tonight's all about she-devils, isn't it? Okay, so this goes to the person who can tell me this. Oh,
raise your hand.
Who directed the 1965 biker chick classic, Motor Psycho? Another great cult director, raise your hand.
Okay, gentleman in the back in the white shirt. Yes, you, waving your hand.
Myers.
Who? Russ Myers, correct.
Come on down!
Consider tonight's film H.G. Lewis's Faster Pussycat.
Here you go, sir.
Whatever that means. Okay. All right, what else we got? Let's do another trivia one. I'm going to move on. We got here from the Ultra Lounge Collection, Mondo Exotica. Great Exotica collection. And that goes to the person who can tell me... Oh, let's see, where's my list? What do we got? Oh, how about this? Troma made a film in the 80s about a biker chick gang fighting the undead. What was the name of that film? Raise your head. Raise your hand, raise your hand. That means nothing to me, I can't see.
Chopper Chicks in Zombie Town.
Chopper Chicks in Zombie Town is correct.
Oh, that classic. Oh, you trivia hound, you.
Billy Joel Fortnite.
Okay.
Be ready, I'll be looking at this direction tonight.
Speaking of Chopper Chicks, I have here
I have a
graphic novel here that basically means comic book. What happened was when 12-year-olds got to be 30, they still wanted to read comics, so they called them graphic novels, which is okay. I still, you know, whatever. But this is called Vamps. It's about a band of biker chick vampires. So lots of pictures, guys. I liked it. And let's see, this goes... Roger Corman reinvented the biker genre in 1967, raise your hand, with this film based on real exploits of the Hells Angels starring Peter Fonda and Nancy Sinatra. What's the name of that film from American International Pictures, 1967? The first big biker film.
All the way in the back.
Wild Angels.
The Wild Angels is correct.
Come on down, you Wild Angel, you. Using good health.
All right, now last time, Monica hasn't spun this wheel for a long time because she was doing a play in Walnut Creek, Proposals by Neil Simon. So when I had my big bachelor show with Mr. Lucky and Mr. Rock and Ensemble a month ago, Connie Champagne was my guest spinner. And
she did well.
Well, we wound up just kind of throwing prizes out to the audience to see who caught them. But she did spin the wheel beforehand. Where'd my wife go? What'd I say to her? Wife. Mrs. Tiki Goddess. There she goes. Connie Champagne, Monica Tiki Goddess, spin the wheel. And here's what I got to give away first. A Demonique Wacky Wobbler. A little She-Devil Wacky Wobbler. Demonique the She-Devil Wacky Wobbler. And this goes to last two numbers. On your ticket. Anyone got their ticket up? Safe tickets? Yep.
They got the red ticket that they gave you when you came in. Not your driver's license. Not your library card, although I know you punks don't have library cards.
White ticket.
Well, if you didn't get a red ticket, you can't get a prize. Hey, if you didn't get a red ticket, that means you came in free. Oh, it is?
It's a white ticket. She got some sunburn over there.
No one tells me anything. Jesus, okay. All right. White ticket, yada, yada, fucking yada, whatever. All right, last two numbers. Number 2, 5. Hey, 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 hey. Don't boo me, it's the wheel.
Whoa. All right, you want to spin again? Okay.
We will remove you from the theater if you cannot calm down. All right, ready? Okay, who has the last two numbers of 8, 3? An 8 and a 3. Woo! Come on up.
Okay.
Hey, Will, we got another 83 back here.
Guy, yes.
Two free passes to the Parkway. Here you go, buddy.
Yeah, I guess she knows what she's doing. I shouldn't say anything. No, of course you do, honey.
I meant to do that.
I'm sure, I know you did. Okay. Anyway, Planet X Magazine, published by Scott Moon, who helps me put on all of my psychotronic shows. I'll be having a Planet X release party at the WearPad in July. And this is his latest issue, the Outer Space issue, cover story by yours truly, interview with Bettina Marcus, who was the Green Lady on Lost in Space. Dr. Smith, remember that broad? Well, you probably don't, but anyway. I found her somewhere in Vegas and interviewed her, and here she is. And so this is the latest issue of Planet X Magazine, and it goes to lucky number...
Okay, we're doing last three numbers now. 304. Bring your ticket up. 104. 104 out there? Okay, who's closest to 104? Well, come up here then, Jesus. We still have a movie to show, people.
We're going to do one more wheel spin, but to help us do that, not that we need any help, I'm going to bring up the Devil Dolls, who are going to come up and say hello. Come on up, gals. Remember, these are the Devil Dolls, Devil-Ettes. They're going to be performing after the movie. So you got to sit through She Devils on Wheels. That's part of the admission price. She's Devil-Ettes, but beforehand, we got the Devil Dolls from San Francisco. Why don't you introduce yourselves?
I'm Goth Girl.
Okay, I like that.
T-Rex.
T-Rex.
Michelle.
So, Goth Girl, why don't you just briefly, just what are the Devil Dolls all about?
We love motorcycles, we ride them, we're like sisters. We bond, we like to cause trouble, set up car alarms, have fun, ride all the time.
So basically tonight's film is about you, pretty much.
Yes. In fact, our next calendar is going to be, we like that illustration on that cover.
I'm glad you mentioned your calendar, because they gave us some to give away. So Monica, why are you busy? We haven't lost yet. Okay. We have here a calendar of the Devil Dolls. Monica's going to spin the wheel, and Goth Girl will hand it out herself. Devil Dolls calendar. What's that?
Girls shot on their own bikes. That's the kind of, they all ride these bikes that they're on.
It was shot?
Yeah.
You got scenes of that? Okay, good.
Pictures, yeah.
All right, okay, carnage throughout the year for sex and violence on bikes. And this goes to lucky number...
83!
Sure, why not?
Yahoos, 4, 2, 9, 1.
Combination of any of those.
Okay, who's close enough? Get over here.
Sure.
Don't forget your ass up here quick enough. Ms. Tiki Goddess. And the Devil Dolls got a little surprise for you here. So stick around, enjoy the movie. Afterward, we got the Devil-Ettes coming on stage right here, live, right at you. So, yeah, that'll do it. Mahalo and aloha. Sean Kelly. Sean. Take it away, Sean.
Thank you very much, Will the Thrill. I'd like to thank you and the beautiful Monica the Tiki Goddess for being such great hosts. We from San Francisco aren't used to people being nice and, chill. We have to compete with everybody for the cool factor. So, I'm here tonight to MC for the Devil-Ettes, and you may be wondering why I'm MCing and John Fast is not Juan Rapido. Well, he couldn't make it, which is why he's sitting right there in the second row. Everybody, big hand for John Fast, the regular MC for the Devil-Ettes. Actually, why I'm here tonight is because I won an auction where I paid a lot of money to become a Devil-Ette, and this is my duty here. I have the full Devil-Ette regalia. I have the little puppy ears, but I still have my Vans on, people. Vans. That's where it's at. The most durable shoes ever.
Let's see a horn.
If you're gonna heckle me, do it one at a time so I can respond. Thank you. Yes, the loincloth is part of my personality. Actually, this came with me when I was born. Okay, so what I'm here to do tonight is to introduce the Devil-Ettes, and without further ado, I think I will do that.
Show us your horn!
My name, by the way, is the Amazon. Or the silky one, whichever you prefer. Okay, so here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, from the beautiful Mission District in San Francisco, California, the women, the Foxtrot, was initially intended to refer to, yes, the ladies who put the cha-cha-cha in Champion, the girls that put the swing in swing. Let's get ready to rumble with the Devil.
Saddlebag. Oh, my leg like snakes, you know. She
Hey,
your breath. So, you guys wanna hear some jokes?
No!
Okay, so, I heard this on the net. These are my friends' jokes. I'm not gonna do my own because they suck. I heard this on the net. I have a badminton net that talks to me exclusively in my backyard. I heard this on the net. Here it is. If you listen to Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon, you know, it's that album with the, it's got the prism and then the, you know, the light goes through it. You know, if you don't recognize it, it's painted on the side of my van outside. And on the other side, there's a unicorn fighting Darth Vader. Yeah, so if you listen to Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon at the same time as watching The Wizard of Oz, you're a big fucking loser. That's right. Also, and I heard this on the web, I have a spider web that talks to me exclusively. If you listen to the new Britney Spears album, Forwards, you're a big fucking loser. That's right. You guys ready?
We want to hear the jokes now.
More jokes!
More jokes. Okay, here's the one-liner. I have this friend, he said, everything I learned in kindergarten. Everything I needed to know, I learned in kindergarten. That's a dumb motherfucker right there. That's right. I asked him what the square root of pie was. He said, it's time for juice and cookies. Okay. You girls ready? All right, here we go. This is the big go-go number. Woo!
Yeah.
the mayor. Few thought this perennial bachelor could ever be pinned down, but they were wrong. Let's bring her up. Along came a tantalizing tiki goddess who slaked her way into his heart and changed everything, people. Changed it all. That's right. Believe it or not, this lucky lounge lizard married the pinup gal of his dreams. On May 31st, 2001, may we present the happy couple, Will the Thrill and Monica the Tiki Goddess. There's your couple. And now let's do some introductions. The saucy one. Step aside, Martha Stewart, because this tomato is cooking up a sauce that's big on spice and even bigger on taste. It's the saucy one. And la habanera. Pica pica es la habanera. La habanera es muy peligrosa porque ella es muy picante. Tenga cuidado con la habanera. The young one. Call the authorities. It's the young one. She'll play hop, scourge on your heart, and petty cake on your self-respect. Ruin your family with the young one. The Rough Rider. Get him up and move him out, Greenhorn, because the Rough Rider's here. Heading up a posse of bad cowgirls to steal the water rats from the ranch of your heart. It's the Rough Rider. The Thrill Seeker. Play bumper cars with a nitroglycerin or do tequila shots off a rabid alligator. It better be wild, because the Thrill Seeker is here and wants the day. Falcon the snowman, the eagle has landed, the reindeer has a boo-boo. She aims to please, but shoots to kill. Phone the commander, it's the assassin. Oh, it's 3 p.m. in the afternoon, but you'll want to count sheep all day long when you're napping with the sleeper. Able to resist her charms, but she'll go go-go over the sultry siren. The Catholic schoolgirl. Oh, Shabbos, call Father O'Flanagan. It's the Catholic schoolgirl tempting us, and I think we'll be needing to confess. And the Hellcat. Oh, the goldfish is missing, and someone dug up the houseplant. Who could it have been? Uh-oh, it's the Hellcat. Bad kitty. Starlet. TC, this is AG. Have I got a girl for you? She'll light up the screen in that new khaki flick. She's the starlet, baby, the starlet. And the bombshell. Danger, danger. Don't get too close to this firecracker, because when she explodes on the scene, not even the bomb squad can save you. It's the bombshell. Ladies and gentlemen, your new couple, Will the Thrill and Monica.
Mrs. Will the Thrill!
Will the Thrill.
Well, we thank you all for that wonderful entrance, but I just want to correct our announcer here. It's actually Mr. and Mrs. Tiki Goddess. Thank you very much.
Well, for the next 10 minutes, sure, why not? Anyway, you've been watching some choice highlights from my honeymoon in Hawaii. There we are at the Polynesian Culture Center in Oahu, which is run by Mormons.
It's kind of scary.
Yeah, I know. So we inadvertently funded some sexy little hula babe to go to Brigham Young University in Hawaii, but that wasn't my intention. My intention was to look at a bunch of tikis, and I did. Anyway, they have tikis all over Hawaii. It's Tikiville, and just like you'd think. I mean, unlike, say, Las Vegas, where, you know, you're in Paris or New York or Treasure Island or some shit, because Vegas is gone. When you're in Hawaii, you feel like you're in Hawaii. It's still Hawaii. That's the beauty of it, which is what I was expecting. We're on the island of Kauai, which is quite beautiful. And Oahu, which is home of Waikiki. We stayed at the Royal Hawaiian. I highly recommend it if you...
Best hotel on the beach.
If you want to go broke for about a year, but it's worth it.
It's worth it.
The Pink Palace. And went to a bunch of luau's. No one there has heard of Martin Denny.
Heard of Ricky Martin, so it kind of evens out.
Has anyone here heard of Martin Denny? That's how I know I'm back home. I'm back home because you've heard of Martin Denny. I mean, it's not like, it was like going around Memphis and like, where's Graceland? They don't know what you're talking about. So, I mean, I had to educate the bartenders on Martin Denny. I had to do the song.
He actually did.
They just cut me off. That's all they did. So, anyway, Don
he
Ho.
He actually gave the bartenders.
My only letdown in Hawaii was Don Ho was in friggin' Chicago. It's like you go to Vegas and Wayne Newton is in, you know, Hong Kong. It's like, I didn't think he was allowed to leave. So no Don Ho for me. I went all the hell over to Waikiki, no Don Ho. But other than that, it was
a
dream.
But I was your hoe, so.
Paradise, exactly. I'm the Don of her world.
Who said
okay.
That?
Anyway.
Did you eat boy?
What's that?
Did you eat boy?
Little bit, just for the experience, and then I moved on.
Then he ate other things.
Yeah.
The pig, you know, at the luau.
And yeah, just call me Porky. Okay. Anyway. Moving on. Tonight we have our honeymoon show to celebrate our first show as a married couple. Monica has not been seen around these parts for quite some time. I did a bachelor party here with Mr. Lucky and Sprocket Ensemble about a month ago, in which Connie Champagne subbed as the wheel spinner.
I let her spin my wheel.
Yeah, she spun mine. In fact, that's how I met Monica. She came to Thrillville, and yeah, we do have to talk about it. She came to Thrillville. And
you can hear everything, honey.
I let her spin the wheel. Well, where do you see the rest of the video? Anyway, so Monica was doing a play, Neil Simon's Proposals in Walnut Creek, so she hasn't been here for a couple months. So she's going to spin the wheel tonight for the first time in a couple months, and the first time is Ms. Tiki Goddess.
Exactly.
Okay, so we're going to get right to that. But the main event here tonight, we have two special guests, special groups of guests. We have, from San Francisco, the Devil-Ettes. Return engagement, they were here December of 99 for my big Tiki night. And we also have the Devil Dolls Motorcycle Club from San Francisco.
They're
looking at their hogs right here.
Speaking of luau, here's their hogs.
So anyway, when I got back from Hawaii, I was in a great mood, and then I picked up the newspaper and was immediately pissed off, because what happened was the AFI, which is what? A lot of fucking idiots?
American
Film Institute.
Imbeciles.
Came out with their most thrilling movies of all time. You know, the same old, you know, Psycho, Jaws, Exorcist, French Connection, Spielberg movies. Okay, whatever. Well, everything everyone's already seen at Blockbuster, you know, 100 times. The point of Thrillville.
What about Valley of Guanji?
Exactly. She's learning.
See what I'm saying? I don't know.
She's learning. She doesn't know what she's talking about, but she's learning. Thrillville is this is the anti-thrillist. I'll tell you why. Because the point of Thrillville is to present films you may not have heard of or have seen. For instance, tonight's film, She-Devil's on Wheels.
Not to be confused with She-Gods of Shark Reef.
Right, which was filmed on Kauai. I saw the locations where Carmen went. She-Devil's on Wheels is not on this list. They picked 100 movies. She-Devil's on Wheels didn't make it. I have no use for a list that does not have She-Devil's on Wheels. I'm making my own fucking list, and I'm starting tonight with She-Devil's on Wheels, which you will agree is one of the most thrilling films of all time. But at least you've seen this week. So before that, though, before all this, I bring on the Devil-Ettes, we're going to actually give out prizes. Is anyone new to this? You know Thrillville etiquette? Monica here, I'm going to do a little trivia. Monica here is going to pick in the dark somebody who can answer a trivia question. you can't really see, so it's going to be pretty random, but I'm going to ask a little question. I have here a gift certificate to the Pacific Coast Brewing Company in downtown Oakland.
If you know the answer, raise your hand, no calling out.
You heard
or one of the she-devils gets to beat the hell out of you.
All right.
Then we'll do something you don't like.
That sounds like a prize. I think that's a prize.
No, sorry. Then we'll do something
else. We have here a gift certificate to Pacific Coast Brewing Company and a little magnetic postcard. She couldn't be good. It was wrong to be bad, but she couldn't be good. For your refrigerator entertainment. And this goes to the person who can tell me this. Herschel Gordon Lewis directed tonight's film. Sleazy Schlockmeister of the 60s and 70s. Whew, it's a lot of liberation. Can't believe I said it. Anyway, I showed a film of his last month, his first big film, gore film, first gore film ever, featured an Egyptian caterer who was also a serial killer. Raise your hand if you know the name of that film.
Okay, I have a Horshack back here. Blonde, yes.
Blood Feast. Blood Feast is correct.
Blood Feast, come on now. Here you go, dear. Right over here. Congratulations.
I got here a book, but it has lots of pictures, so don't worry. Invasion of the B-Girls. All your favorite B-movie actresses right here, from the past right up to the present.
And they are referring to cups.
If you can raise your hand, raise your hand and tell me nicely. In the 80s, maybe 90s, I don't know.
Whatever.
Those aren't my decades, I don't know. But sometime in that period, Troma released a film about a gang of biker chicks Battle the Undead. What was the name of that film?
No calling out. I don't call on anyone who yells.
Whoa. I yell. You call on me sometimes. Oh, that's after.
That's different.
Okay.
Raise your hand. All right. How about this nice gentleman right here in the middle?
Chopper Chicks in Zombie Town.
Chopper Chicks in Zombie Town. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Got to teach you Mook some kind of etiquette here.
Okay, we mentioned Roger Corman, who directed the classic She Gods of Shark Reef on the great island of Kauai back in the 50s. I have here Mondo Exotica from Ultra Lounge. Great for your next tiki party. Great lounge music, Exotica. To the person who can raise their hand and tell me this, in 1967, Roger Corman pretty much defined and kicked off the whole biker film movement with this film featuring Peter Fonda and Nancy Sinatra, released by American International Pictures. What was the name of that film? Raise your hand. It was based on the Hell's Angels.
This here in the middle?
Wasn't that Easy Rider?
No, not Easy Rider.
Easy Rider was 2 years afterwards.
Okay, yes.
Wild Bunch?
Close.
Close, over here.
Hell's Angels on Wheels.
Okay, you put those together and what do you got? Raise your hand.
Wait, raise your hand. Okay, over here.
Wild Angels.
Wild Angels. Wild Angels, come on down. To a Parkway regular, here you go. We're gonna call the four numbers on your ticket. If I screw this up, what the hell? I'm a goddess. I should be having to deal with this shit anyway.
Plus she has sunburn. Okay. All right. First prize we got here, we got a little wacky wobbler. We got here El Diablo. Little El Diablo, wacky wobbler. Little devil.
Wacky wobbler.
Wacky wobbler. Ain't that wacky? I got a bunch of them. I love these things. El Diablo. I think he's Spanish. I guess so, yeah. Spanish? Yeah, so am I now. Will Cortez Thrill. All right, we got your lovely Waikiki in the background. There's Diamond Head. Our view from Rob Boy. Anyway, what do we got? Number what?
3-7-1-1 You're not out there? Okay, we're gonna re-spin.
Why don't you just say the numbers in a different order?
Okay, no. 4-3-1-1 No.
Spin the wheel!
Spin it, baby. I can narrate the film here. They're still on Waikiki Beach. All right, green sand. You can't tell with the video. White sand, green ocean. Was it green sand, a white ocean? I don't know. It was great. Okay, what do we got? Okay.
We need to move on. Okay, So, let's see. Number 4-0-2-9.
These guys are in a hurry. Let's beat this up.
Here we go.
All right, we got here on a wheel spin. Planet X magazine, the outer space issue, published by my friend Scott Moon, who helps me put on my psychotronic film shows. We'll be having a release party for this at the Wearpad next month. Check out Thrillville.net. And I wrote the cover story, interview with Fatina Marcus, who is the green girl in Lost in Space. And no one remembers who that is, but now you can learn all about her. She's lost in Vegas right now. Okay.
All right, number 3, 5, 4, 6. Honey, if you were a goddess, you'd be able to read it too. Sorry. 3, 5, 4, 6. Are you out there? All right.
Let's do it this way. Does anyone remember what TV show Bettina Marcus was on? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. What was that? Raise your hand.
Right here.
You're right.
Come on now.
What a trivia hound. Okay. That must be your favorite show. How did you know that? I must watch it all the time. Big Bettina Marcus fan, are you?